What does it mean to know your limits? Pertaining to art, maybe we think about what we're really good at to what we really aren't. Yet, I don't agree. I don't believe that when it comes to our capacity to draw, paint, create, in general, we have limitations. I don't believe in that. There are endless possibilities to create, to try something new, to discover and learn. No, what I mean pertains to knowing our own specific limitations. Limitations of thyself, which honestly can be quite difficult to learn. I'll be honest, for this video, I had a completely different script in mind to talk about. Yet, when I sat down, finished up my recording for this speed draw, I blanked. It's not that I didn't know what to talk about. It was that I didn't feel passionate enough about the subject I wanted to discuss. Now, I could have sat down that Sunday. I could have forced myself to hash out such a script, hit record, throw it all into editing, and crank out another video by my usual upload time, which is 10 a.m. on Monday Mountain Time. But that didn't happen. I full well knew if I forced myself, I would have entered the early stages of burnout. So, I stopped writing that script. I sent out a small update on my Twitter and discussion page stating that this week's video is going to be late, and kept it at that. That being said, let me just say that you guys are so awesome, being so understanding and patient. I couldn't ask for a better community, and I can't thank you enough for that. Thank you guys so much. That aside, it's sort of interesting that by taking a step back, this topic then came to me, and I felt it was a perfect opportunity to discuss. Knowing your limits is a journey in itself. To know your limits, you have to know yourself, and that can be tricky. Let me give you a rundown of what my weekly schedule looks like. Monday through Friday, I get up around 6 in the morning, arrive to work by 7:45, and don't come home until maybe 4:30, the earliest. There are some days I am beat and want to do nothing except watch videos, relax, game, or chat with my friends. Once the weekend rolls around, Saturday, I get up, I go to the gym, and am supposed to record coming back. Sometimes that doesn't all happen. And for the past 2 or so weeks, I've spent Sunday scrambling to try and put something together, edit, upload, etc., in preparation for Monday. But that didn't happen this week. This week, Sunday afternoon, I was spent. I was exhausted. I had the capacity to realize and remain self-aware that, yeah, I'm maxed out. I've reached my limit. So I needed to stop what I currently was working on and diverted attention to what I needed to do to rest and reset. I spent the rest of Sunday chatting with my bestie and playing some Genshin, and that actually really helped me unwind. But let's go back with the what if. What if I decided going against that small reprieve? What if I just kept going and finished hashing out that video and had it uploaded? Well, for one, I'm going to say that the quality, most likely, wouldn't be very good. My heart wouldn't be in it, and if I feel my enthusiasm won't translate, then I'm positive you would be able to tell that too. So if it weren't for the fact that I knew my limitations, I very well may have produced something that was less than favorable. I know for a fact a few years ago, I would have done one of two things. I would have A, pushed forward, no holds barred, exhaust myself into a state of premature burnout, or B, I would have ghosted my channel without warning, not even a small update via Twitter or on the channel itself about my situation. So the fact that I can recognize that I am at my limit is something I am practicing rather recently. It's hard to break out of those old two habits, but in the end, it's worth working on myself so I can get back to creating and back to producing more wonderful art and content. Now, this is what I've learned through personal experience and am still in the process of knowing the ins and outs. When I think what's my limit, I imagine it as filling a cup with water. And the only way it empties is by evaporating. And everybody's cup is different. Some people have the capacity to carry larger cups and can hold a lot more, while others may only be able to hold a quarter or half as much as someone else. Anyway, throughout the day, with each task I do, it adds water to my cup. Then the activities I do to unwind evaporate that water, and hopefully the next day I will have a completely empty cup ready for tomorrow's water. Some tasks might give a sprinkle, a few droplets. Others may immediately fill up to half and you spend a lot of energy carrying out that task. When our cup is full, that's it. That's our limit. But it's so very easy to overlook. And sometimes we take on more than we can handle, and that's when the water starts to overflow. Sadly, we can't turn our cup upside down, empty it, reset, refresh, right side up, and ready for the day. The water only empties by evaporating, which takes time, including all the water that has spilt over as well. It's not going anywhere until it evaporates. Taking time to yourself, figuring out what helps you unwind when you are at your limit, comprehending and understanding your limitations will prevent overflow. This, in turn, helps prevent becoming burned out or stress. That level of self-awareness, that self-care, it's so difficult to practice, but I can say it does get easier. One of the things that's helped me is telling myself, I am not a machine that can crank out content, art, etc. I am human. So, when I had the option to finish said video and upload it, I took a look at my cup, which was close to full, and declined the next task, which would have created a lot more overflow. Like, I could see life holding this pitcher of water, ready to pour, but I politely declined and honestly am much better off for it. And that's the thing though. Once the water is poured into my cup, I can't do much about it except wait till it evaporates, but I can make the choice to stop while I'm ahead. By doing so, I can prevent overflow, but this isn't easy. Especially, imagine the pitcher that life holds isn't always transparent. Some tasks have the picture completely blacked out, and other tasks, you look at the picture and you can see through it. You can see the water. When we meet these blacked out picture tasks, we have no idea how much water the task will bring. It is by doing them we learn how much water is actually in the picture. The picture will eventually become translucent, and once it does, we're allowed to see how much water it contains. From there, we can start to look at how much volume certain tasks will take up. Then have the option to either add that water to our cup, or see it's a bit too much and politely decline, like, nah, no thanks. Though I have to say, for the longest time, I felt I couldn't refuse, that I should and need to take on more tasks and complete them because it needs to get done. But when it comes to my comics or art, I have to take a step back. Specifically for comics, I can actually break down every page into sections, so that's why I don't feel overwhelmed needing to complete one page in a day ASAP. It's the same thing for my art. Breaking and dividing it up into sections so that way it doesn't seem that I should produce a final product in a short amount of time. I divide the volume of water in the pitcher into smaller pitchers, and there are some days when I look at my almost full cup and just have to stop. Tell myself I can't take on anymore, and I need to pull away and do something that takes from my cup rather than adding to it. Also, be on the lookout for key indicators in yourself that's starting to basically say that your cup is full. My biggest key indicator is I start to become frustrated or impatient at the self-made workload in front of me. Once I start getting antsy about my time and feeling like I just have so much weight on me, that the world is all falling apart, that's a good indicator of whoa. That's my body and mind's way of saying, whoa, Akimi, you're at your limit. You need to stop and do something else. So I ask you, when was the last time you thought about when you're maxed out? When do you know you're just done for the day, reached your limit? What are the key indicators that tell you, hey, you need a rest? Tell me in the comments below, as I just would love to read them. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. Give it a like, comment below what you think, and subscribe so you never stay out of the loop with this girl's content. And I will see you in the next one. And remember, everybody, be awesome. Be you. Akemi. Out.